गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ द जेवियर्स कन्नौज। स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द लास्ट लेक्चर ऑफ द मैट्रिक्स एंड इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मैट्रिसेस एंड देयर प्रॉपर्टीज व्हिच विल आस्क इन योर कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट टुडेज टॉपिक। इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड ट्रायंगुलर मैट्रिसेस, मिनिमम नंबर ऑफ जीरोज इन अ ट्रायंगुलर मैट्रिसेस, मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ डिस्टिंक्ट एलिमेंट इन अ ट्रायंगुलर मैट्रिक्स, ऑर्थोगोनल मैट्रिक्स, दिस ऑल आर द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट विच वी हैव डिस्कस इन द लास्ट लेक्चर। नाउ इन टुडेज लेक्चर द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज आइडेंपोटेंट मैट्रिक्स। Idempotent matrix. The definition of idempotent matrix: a square matrix for which A square is equals to A. A square matrix for which A square is equals to A. Then this kind of square matrices are said to be idempotent matrix. Definition, I think it is clear. A square matrix for which A square is equals to A, then A is said to be the idempotent matrix. Let us consider an example. Let A is equals to a matrix is given. -2, -4, -1, 3, 4, 1, -2 and -3. We need to find A square. Now A square can be written A into A. A is equals to 2, -2, -4, -1, 3, 4, 1, -2, -3. 2, -2, -4, -1, 3, 4, 1, -2, -3. Yes. Find the multiplication. The first matrix, first row. Second matrix, first column. 2 to the 4. -2 into -1, +2. -4 into 1, -4. Now, 1, 2. -2 into -2, -4. 2 into 3, -6. And this is your +8. 2 into 4, -8. -8, +12. -2, -3, +4. 2, +9, -8. 4, +12, +12, -12. 2, +2, -3. -2, -6, +6. -4, -8, +9. Now solve here. If you will solve this one, 4 plus 2, 6, 6 minus of 4 equals to 2. -6, -4, -10, -10, +8 equals to -2. -8, -8, 16. -16, +4, -4. 3 to 5, -5, +4, -1. 9 to 11, 11 minus 8, 3. 4 plus 12, 16, 16. Or this can be cancelled here. Simply it is your 4. 2 plus 2, 4, 4 minus 3, 1. +6, -6 cancel, -2. 8 and 4, -12, -12 and +9. That is equals to -3. See the question, what is the definition of the idempotent matrix? A square matrix is said to be idempotent matrix if A square equals to A. We have taken an example, A equals to a square matrix of order 3 by 3. We have calculated simply A square, it means A into A. by the multiplication rule. We have simply multiplied them, and after solving we are getting 2 minus 2, and if you will observe the matrix A, it is exactly equals to A here. So what results we have observed from here? A square equals to A, then we can say here ki A is a which type of matrix? Idempotent matrix. Clear to everyone?
Okay.
Now we are going to discuss some properties of the idempotent matrix. Properties of the idempotent matrix. Property number 1. A square is equals to A. The property number 1 says here, if A square is equals to A, then it can be determinant can be taken to the both sides. And determinant of A square into determinant of A. How to take the determinant? We have discussed some points when we are discussing the orthogonal matrix. So this can be written here. Determinant of A square, and shift to this side, determinant of A equals to 0. Here determinant of A can be taken out common, then determinant of A minus of 1 equals to 0. Now either determinant of A equals to 0 or determinant of A minus 1 equals to 0, therefore determinant of A equals to 1. So we have discussed, actually the first property is there, if A is a idempotent matrix, if A is an idempotent matrix, then there will be only the two determinant can be possible. Two determinant can be possible. Either the determinant will be equals to 0 or either the determinant will be equals to 1. This is very very important point. Suppose that if we need to prove that which are the idempotent matrix, then this is the one of the property. If the determinant of A is equals to 0, if the determinant of A equals to 0, and the property is that determinant of A must be 0 and determinant of A must be 1. Getting the point? So this is a very important point. The first property, if A is an idempotent matrix, then determinant of A equals to 0 and determinant of A equals to 1. Second property. Think here, if determinant of A is equals to 0 is there. Determinant of A is equals to 0. What will be happen? We have discussed ki the idempotent matrix is there, then only the two cases can be possible. Either the determinant will be equals to 0 or either the determinant will be equals to 1. Now the second property is there. If the determinant of an idempotent matrix, it is given that A is an idempotent matrix. A is an idempotent matrix and the determinant is equals to 0. Determinant is equals to 0. Then we can say here, we have discussed the points in the orthogonal matrix when we are discussing. If any square matrix, for any square matrix, if determinant is equals to 0, then what the name of matrix is there? A is said to be singular matrix. Singular matrix. A is said to be singular matrix. And A is said to be singular means here A inverse will not exist. Not exist. Getting the point? A inverse will not exist. The meaning of this question is there. The meaning of this whole point is that if A is an idempotent matrix, then there will be only two conditions. Either the determinant of A will be equals to 0 or either the determinant of A equals to 1. Now, what happens if determinant of A equals to 0? Then determinant of A equals to 0, all the conditions we are talking for the idempotent matrix. If determinant of A equals to 0, then A is said to be singular matrix. And yes, A inverse will not exist. Just we have discussed the example when we are discussing this given matrix is idempotent or not. the matrix we have taken 2 minus 2 minus 4 minus 1 3 4 1 minus 2 minus 3. See here, we have also proved for the example there that A square is equals to A was there. Then definitely it is an idempotent matrix. If it is an idempotent matrix, then we are going to check the determinant of this matrix. Determinant of this matrix. If it is idempotent, then only two determinants can be possible. Either it can be 0 or either it can be 1. So now check here the determinant of this one. I told you how to expand the determinant through the first row. Take the sign plus, this is minus, and this is the plus. 2 there, if you will 2, then what will happen? This will cancel. What will be left here? 3, 4, minus 2, minus 3. Now, principal diagonal product, 3 into minus 3, minus of 9. Minus 8 and minus sign there, then this is plus 8. Here the minus sign is there, then minus sign and minus of 2. This will cancel, this will cancel. This is your 3 into 1, 3 and minus of 4. Plus of 4. It is plus and this is your actually the sign of 4 is your minus 4. Now this is cancel, this is cancel. 2 into 1, 2, 3 into 1, 3. Solve this one. 9 minus, minus 9 plus of it, minus 1, minus 2. 4 minus 1. Actually this is your minus 1, here the sign is also minus, then minus minus plus of 2 into minus 1, minus 2. Now 3 into, this is minus 1 and minus 1 into minus 4, this is plus 4. 2 into plus 4 and minus 4, it will cancel and this will be becomes equals to 0. So we have just get the result here. The first proof we have discussed, if determinant, if A is an idempotent matrix, then the two cases was there, either the determinant of A will be equals to 0 or either the determinant of A is equals to 1. The second point we have discussed is when A is your determinant of A is 0, then singular matrix and A inverse will not exist. So this is the case for this one. Third property is, third property says here, if A, determinant of A is not equals to 0, not equals to 0 means it can, not equals to 0 means definitely this will be A is equals to 1 only, determinant of A is equals to 1 only, because we have only the two cases, either the 0 or either it can be 1. So if it is not 0, then it will be 1. Achha, if it is not 0, then A is your non-singular. A is your non-singular. Non-singular means A inverse will exist. A inverse will exist. What will happen if A inverse will exist? Then A square equals to A. This we all are discussing for the idempotent matrix. Can it be multiplied to the pre-multiplication with the A inverse? Pre-multiplication with the A inverse and A square can be written A into A and that is equals to A inverse into A. This will be equals to I into A and A inverse into A that is equals to I. Now we are getting here A is equals to I. This is very important result. If A is an idempotent matrix, and how is the A? A is your non-singular matrix. Non-singular matrix means its determinant is not equals to 0. Then we have just calculated the result. A must be identity matrix. There is no any other case. When the determinant is not equals to 0, then A must be equals to the identity matrix. There is no any other case except the identity. Check the result here. Suppose A is equals to identity matrix 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. A is an identity matrix of order 3. What is the determinant of this one? I told you how to find a determinant of identity matrix. Simply multiply the diagonal elements. This is your 1, 1, 2, 1 into 1. Determinant is equals to 1. Now we need to check here. A is an identity matrix, determinant is equals to 1, then find the value of A square. A square means A into A. 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. Solve this one. If you will multiply these two matrices, you will get here 1 identity matrix, and we are proving here the A square, A is equals to, if we have taken here identity and A can be also written I there, then actually this is your A square means I square, I into I, and what we are getting I, then I square equals to I. So this is the condition for the idempotent matrix. And if the idempotent matrix determinant is 1, then it is only possible when the matrix is your identity matrix. This is the very important point here. So till now what we have discussed for the idempotent matrix? The idempotent matrix, a square matrix, is said to be idempotent matrix for which A square equals to A. Then A is said to be the idempotent matrix. We can check that. How we can check that the idempotent or not? Then simple example is there. Any matrix is given there. We need to check that the given matrix is idempotent or not. Then just multiply them and get the result. If it is coming A square equals to A, then it is idempotent matrix. Properties of idempotent matrix, the first property was there. If the A is an idempotent matrix, then its determinant will be either equals to 0 or either equals to 1. If it is your 0, then it is said to be singular, and in this case inverse will not exist. And if it is your non-singular, then their inverse will exist. And if it is non-singular, then only the matrix will be identity matrix. That's it. Last point of the properties of the idempotent matrix. If A is an idempotent matrix, then I'm going to take the result here. Find the value of AQ first. AQ can be written A square into A. What A square is equals to actually? A square can be written A into A, and that is A square, and A square is equals to A. Then if it is idempotent, then we can say AQ, if we are going to calculate the value of AQ, it is again coming A. Find the value of A4. It can be written A square into A square. A square can be written A. A square can be written A. Now when it is your A square, and again A square can be written A. Similarly, a to the power 5 can be written a to the power 4 into a. A to the power 4 we have calculated a into a, and a square, and that is equal to a. Observe the pattern here. Whatever the power of a we are taking here, 3, 4, 5, sorry. Whatever the power we are taking, the positive power of the positive index for the a here, in every cases we are getting A here. In every cases we are getting A. And what the property number 4 says? The property number 4 says here, the A to the power K, if A is an idempotent matrix, then A to the power K is equals to A. A to the power K is equals to A, where, what is K? K is your positive natural number. K is your positive natural number. Getting the point? This is the very important point. If A is an idempotent matrix, then A to the power K equals to A, where K is your positive natural number. This is the four properties of the idempotent matrix. Moving to the next point. Involutory matrix. What is the definition here? A square matrix A is said to be involutory matrix. A square matrix A is said to be involutory matrix if a square is equals to I. If a square is equals to I, what is the meaning here? In the case of idempotent matrix, we have discussed if A is said to be the idempotent matrix, then A square equals to A, and now if A square is equals to I, then that is said to be the involutory matrix. How the question will be asked in your examination? Suppose any matrix is given, and it will ask that to check that the given matrix is idempotent matrix, involutory matrix, or orthogonal matrix. Then simply you can apply the property there. Find A square. If it is coming A, then that is idempotent. If it is coming A square equals to I, then it is involutory. And if it is coming A into A transpose is equals to I, then it is your orthogonal. Okay. Now, involutory matrix. Let us take an example of the involutory matrix. A is equals to minus 5, minus 8, 0, 3, 5, 0, 1, 2, minus 1. Find here A square. Now A into A, it can be written minus 5, minus 8, 0, 3, 5, 0, 1, 2, minus 1. Minus 5, minus 8, 0, 3, 5, 0, 1, 2, minus 1. 5 into 5, 25. Minus of 24. And this is your 0. 5 into 8, 40. Minus of 40. And 0. 0, 0, 0. This is minus of 15. Plus of 15. 0. This is minus 24, plus 25, 0. 0 plus 0 plus 0. Minus of 5, plus of 6, minus of 1. Minus 8, plus of 10, minus 2. 1 plus 0, plus 0, plus of 1. If you will solve this one, 1, 0, 0. This will be 0, this is your 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Now we can say this is an identity matrix. So we can say that A is equals to the given matrix, and we are finding A square, then we are getting I, then this matrix A is said to be which kind of matrix? Involutory matrix. Clear? This is a very simple point. We can check that the given matrix is involutory, idempotent, or orthogonal. Now the properties is very important. The properties are very important. The first property of idempotent matrix. Involutory matrix. Clearly we can say A square is equals to I. Now what we can say if A square is equals to I? What is the first property? We can say here the determinant of if A is involutory matrix. If A is an involutory matrix, then determinant of A is equals to plus minus 1. What was the case in the case of idempotent matrix? It was 0, 1. Now, the first property is there. If A is an involutory matrix, then the determinant of that matrix is either 1 or either minus 1. How it can be checked here? A square equals to I. Can we take the determinant to the both sides? Okay, now A square can be written, determinant of A whole square, and identity matrix determinant, I told you, find the product of the diagonal elements, 1 into 1 into 1, that is your 1. So now A determinant is equals to under root of 1, and determinant of A coming, we are getting here plus minus 1. This is very important result. In the case of involutory matrix, the determinant of that matrix will be either 1 or either it will be minus 2. Second property. This is also very important one. Second property. Second property says that if A is an involutory matrix, then inverse of A will be equals to A. If A is involutory matrix, then inverse of A will be equals to A. What is the meaning of this one? Inverse of A will be equals to A. The meaning of this, how it can be there, how it can be proved, A square equals to I. A square equals to I, since determinant is either 1 or either minus 1, so definitely it is not 0. Not 0 means it is non-singular. Non-singular means inverse will exist pre-multiplication with A inverse. Now A inverse into A, I into A. A inverse into I, A inverse. Can it be written here? I into A equals to A and A inverse. So we are getting here ki if any matrix for which the inverse of A is equals to A, the inverse of A is equals to A, then we can say here ki the given matrix is your involutory matrix. Clear? These two very important properties we have discussed. Next property, the third one. Before adding the property, let A square, since A is involutory matrix, then A square equals to I, find A cube. What A cube can be written? A square into A. A square is equals to A square equals to I. I into A. And that is equals to A to the power 4. A to the power 4 can be written A cube into A. A cube we have calculated A and into A. A into A means A square equals to A5. A6. A5 can be written A4 into A. A4 equals to actually I into A and that is equals to A6. A5 into A. A5 actually it is your A into A and that is equals to A square and that is equals to A. Observe the pattern here. If A to the power 3, then that is equals to A. If A to the power 5, then that is equals to A. But if A to the power 4 is there, then we are getting I. If A to the power 6 is there, then we are getting I. By observing this pattern, can we say here, ki when we are taking the power of the matrix as an odd number, power of matrix as an odd number, then in every cases we are getting A. And when we are taking power of the matrix as an even number, then we are getting an identity matrix. Clear to everyone? So, if A is an involutory matrix, the third property is there. The third property says here, ki A to the power n will gives you the two value. A to the power n will gives you the two value. A to the power n will gives you A. And one time it will gives you I. When it will gives you your A, when we can say n is odd number. Can we say here? Okay, when the power of the, when the index of A is an odd number, then A to the power n will be given by A. And when n is even number, then we can say A to the power n is your an identity matrix. This is the very, very important result here. Ki when A is an involutory matrix, then A to the power n will give you the two result. This will give you A when n is an odd number, and this will give you an identity matrix when n is your even number. There, the three results we have discussed in the case of involutory matrix. Third point is your nilpotent matrix. Nilpotent matrix. A square matrix A is said to be nilpotent matrix. A square matrix A is said to be nilpotent matrix. Nilpotent matrix if A to the power n is equals to 0. If A to the power n is equals to 0. Where, what is n here? N is positive natural number. Where n is the positive natural number. These all the points which we are discussing, idempotent matrix, involutory matrix, nilpotent matrix, orthogonal matrix, what is common in all the cases? They The common point is that all the matrices must be square matrix. All the matrices must be square matrix. So a kind of square matrix for which a to the power n equals to 0, where n is the positive n, positive natural number, positive, we can say here positive integers here, positive n here it means, or positive integers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever it is the term here, positive integers must be there. So a to the power n is equals to 0, then we can say here ki the given matrix is nilpotent matrix. Let us consider an example of the nilpotent matrix here. If A is equals to 5A² here, if A is a matrix here, find A square, A into A, if you will find here 0AB, 0, 0, C, 0, 0, 0, 0AB, 0, 0, C, 0, 0, 0. If you will find here the product of the two matrices, this is your 0. Again, this is your 0. This is your 0. This is A into C. This is your AC. 0 plus AC plus 0. Now you are multiplying 0. This will be 0. This will be 0. All 3 0, 0. This is the value of A square. Now find the value of A cube. Find the value of A cube. A cube means A square into A. A square equals to 0, 0, AC. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. And into A. A is equals to 0, AB, 0, 0, C, 0, 0, 0. Find the product here. This will be 0, this will be 0, and this will be 0. All will be 0 here. So the point is that, what is involutory matrix? A square matrix A is said to be involutory matrix, for which A to the power N is equals to 0. The least value of N, we need to find the least value of N. And how is the n? N is the positive integer. It means least value of n for which a to the power n must be 0 are said to be involutory matrix. So, in this case, for this matrix, square matrix A, if we have calculated A square, then we are getting this one. This is not all the elements are 0. But when we are calculating A cube, then we are getting all the elements 0. Then can we say here, here a to the power 3 is equals to 0 and a to the power 3 is equals to a null matrix. So it is just following the property here, a to the power n equals to 0, a to the power n equals to 0. It means that here A is an nilpotent matrix. Nilpotent matrix. A is a nilpotent matrix. For what? For the power. What is the index of the A here? The index of A is your 3. The least value of N for which A becoming 0. The least value of N for which A to the power N is becoming 0. Then what is the least value of A here? The least value of A is your 3. So this 3 is called the index there. Index of A, and that is equals to 3. So A is a nilpotent matrix, and what is the order of the, what is the index of the nilpotent matrix? The index of the nilpotent matrix is 3. Clear? This is a very important point. Again, I am repeating the definition of the nilpotent matrix. A square matrix A is said to be nilpotent matrix if A to the power N is equals to 0, where what is N? N is the least value of the N, least value of positive integers for which A to the power N is becoming 0.
So in this case, we can say here the least is an nilpotent matrix, and what is the index of the index of the nilpotent matrix? The index of the nilpotent matrix is 3. Okay. The value of n for which a to the power n is 0, this n is called the index here. Now, very important point note is here. If you will observe the matrix which we have used here, actually we have taken 0AB, 00C, 000. If you will observe the matrix here, which kind of matrix actually this one? This matrix is your, all the elements below the diagonal elements are 0. Then that is said to be the, all the elements below the diagonal elements are 0, then that is said to be the upper triangular matrix. We can also take the lower triangular matrix. Then what is the note point? If a square matrix is a triangular matrix means either it can be upper or either it can be lower, then the square matrix which is triangular matrix, this matrix will be a nilpotent matrix. Every triangular matrix will be nilpotent matrix. And what will be the index of the nilpotent matrix? The index of the nilpotent matrix will be equals to or less than the order of the matrix. Again repeating their point, keep all the triangular matrices are said to be the nilpotent matrix. All the triangular matrices are said to be the nilpotent matrix. And what is the index of the nilpotent matrix? The index of the nilpotent matrix, what is the index we have calculated? The index was equals to 3. So the definition is there. The index of all the nilpotent matrix, which is your what? Which is your triangular matrix, the index will be, smaller than or equals to the order of the given matrix. What is the order here? The order actually also 3 there. Then either here index must be either 3 or smaller than 3. It is just, we can say here it is just the power of A and the order of the matrix 3. We are getting the, this is satisfying actually, this we can say this is satisfying this result. The index of the A is smaller than equals to the order of the given matrix. Next note point. If A is an nilpotent matrix, then A to the power K equals to 0. Taking the determinant here, that is also equals to 0. Now A to the power determinant equals to 0, then determinant of A equals to 0. This is very obvious. If A is a nilpotent matrix, then the determinant value of that nilpotent matrix will be always equals to 0. Last note point. If A is a matrix which is your null matrix, Is this matrix a nilpotent matrix? Yes, all the null matrices are nilpotent matrix. And what is the index of that nilpotent matrix? The index of the nilpotent matrix is equals to 1. This is very, very important point for the objective point of view. If A is a null matrix, then this A will be nilpotent. This A will be nilpotent for which index? For the index 1. Clear to everyone? Okay. The last point of the matrix now. Periodic matrix. Now what is periodic matrix? A square matrix A is said to be periodic matrix if A to the power k plus of 1 is equals to A, where k is positive integers, and k is smallest value, and k is the smallest value, then we say period of matrix A is k. What is the meaning of this periodic matrix? If A is a square matrix such that A to the power k plus 1 equals to A, and how is the k? Then k is the all positive integers. Now, from all the positive integers, we need to just select such a k which is the smallest one. K is the smallest value, then we say, it means that value of k which is the smallest one, then that is said to be the periodicity. It means that is said to be the periodicity of the matrix. Just try to relate this topic to the one topic was there in class 11th. While we have discussed the general solution of the trigonometric function. Let us consider the example of sin x. We have discussed the graph of the sine function, and just we came to know that the sine function is periodic at an interval of 2 pi. The meaning of the periodicity means at interval of 2 pi, the sine functions repeated its value. Then this 2 pi is the smallest value at which the sine function repeated its value. So the periodicity of the function is 2 pi. Getting the point? Similarly, in the case of this periodic matrix, we can say here the A to the power k is equals to A, then such smallest value of k is said to be the periodicity of the matrix if A to the power k plus 1 is equals to A. Just example, suppose k is equals to 4 is there. It is given that the k is equals to 4 is the periodicity of the matrix A. Then definitely A to the power k plus of 1, if you will apply the formula, then A to the power 4 plus of 1, A to the power 5, and that is equals to A. Now, if A to the power 5 equals to A, it means at how much interval the function will repeat its value? At the interval of 4. Then 5 plus 4, that is equals to 9. Definitely A to the power 9 can be written here. A to the power 5 into A to the power 4, and A to the power 5 equals to A, and A to the power 4 again A to the power 5, and A to the power 5 equals to A. At how much interval now? Again add 4 here, then 9 plus 4 equals to 13. A to the power 9 into A to the power 4. Now A to the power 9 equals to A, and A to the power 4, A to the power 5, and that equals to A. Then similarly, at the interval of 4, the function will repeat its value. This is the concept of the periodic matrix. Okay. Last point of the matrix chapter, trace of a matrix. If A be a square matrix, then the trace of the matrix is denoted by TRA, and it is defined as sum of all the diagonal elements. Now, it can be written, sum of all the diagonal elements can be written. Suppose we are discussing a square matrix of order n by n. Then the diagonal elements are denoted by a11, a22, a33, and so on to how many diagonals? N diagonals, then ann. It can be also written like this, aii, because for the diagonal elements I and j both are same and I starts from 1 to n. This is called the trace of a matrix. Example, suppose A is a square matrix. A, B, C, 0, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now what is the trace of A here? The trace of A will be your A plus 2 plus 4, sum of all the diagonal elements. Then A plus 2 plus 4 equals to A plus 6, this is the required value. And if it is given that the trace of A is equals to 5, the question can be asked here, trace of A is equals to, suppose trace of A is equals to 5, then A plus of 6 is equals to 5, then what will be the value of A here? A is equals to minus of 1, objective question can be asked here. Clear? This is a very simple point, trace of a matrix. Now the properties of trace of a matrix. Properties of trace of a matrix. The first point. Trace of the two matrices, the sum of the two matrices can be written trace of A plus trace of B. If it is plus sign then separated by plus, if it is minus sign then separated by minus sign. The proof is not required there, only you need to just memorize the result. Trace of lambda times of A. Lambda is a scalar quantity, then lambda will be taken out and that will be trace of A. Trace of identity matrix, this is very important word, trace of identity matrix. If it is your I3, identity matrix of order 3, then the trace of I3 can be written 1 plus 1 plus of 1, that is 3. If it is 2, then 1 plus 1, 2 times you will add 1. If it is your n order, it means n times 1 we will add, then n times 1 it will be, if it is your n order of n times identity matrix, then the trace of identity matrix of order n will be your n. Trace of A to the power n. Trace of A to the power n, this is a very important formula. This is your n times trace of A. N times trace of A. This is also very important formula. Fifth one. Trace of AB. This is equals to trace of BA. Now, how to just memorize the formula of this one? Just make a circle. This the order of the circular order you have to maintain here. If it is your A, then it is B now. Now the order of the circle, this circular order you have to maintain. If it is your AB, then what will be the next order? BA? Then it is BA. Suppose we are taking the three matrices now. See there, then ABC. Trace of ABC. Then order must not be changed. ABC. Can it be written BCA? Then trace of BCA is equals to trace of CAB. CAB. This is a very important formula also. Trace of AB is equals to trace of BA. This is the properties of the, these all are the properties of the trace of the matrices. And this is the end of the matrix chapter here. We have discussed all the entire part of the matrices chapter in the two segments we can say here. One we can say the exactly the your examination point of view, board examination point of view, and another we can say in the competitive examination point of view. Those students who are preparing for the competitive exam, those students must see these two last two videos there where we have discussed so many things regarding the matrices chapter. I had also given in the WhatsApp group the 25 questions sheet there. You need to solve these all the questions and whatever the queries are there you can ask there. Now one very important information for you all the students, after completing from my side it is completed. Now this is your turn to just each and every student from the class 11th A must have to complete their work, and you have to send your work on the WhatsApp group in the PDF format. Within two days, today is your, I think, Friday, then Saturday and Sunday, you have the time there. Complete this, all the syllabus, complete all the exercise from 3.1 to the miscellaneous. Whatever the queries are there, just ask your queries and just try to solve all the questions from your exercise and from the sheet which I had given. From Monday, we will start the next chapter, matrices. Till then, take care. Goodbye.